Okay, I'm going to paint this little umbrella down on my terrace. We're just about done with our scene back here. The last step in this is to paint our umbrella. It's sketched in, and now I'm using mixtures. This is a mix of cadmium yellow medium, plus a little bit of mud, which is alizarin crimson and ultramarine blue, and then some, just a touch more alizarin crimson. I want this to be yellow, but I don't want it to be just a real bright, bright, bright yellow, because I need it to stay back into the background. So I've added the mud and a little bit of alizarin crimson into that, just so it'll drop back here. But I thought this would just give a nice little vibrant touch in the background. Little interest. Now the sun is hitting this edge of the umbrella. And each of these panels is a different shade. The one getting the most light will, of course, be the lightest. That is a mix of my cadmium yellow medium plus a little bit of mud in it and a little bit of alizarin crimson. Same mixture as the same colors to make this mix as the darker, but the darker has more mud in it and alizarin crimson in it. Now this is a mix of just my cadmium yellow medium plus a little tiny bit of mud. Just a little bit. Well, my sketch is not dry, which my sketch is. I had to redraw my umbrella because I had it up too high. So that sketch part is still of mud, is still wet, so I'm pulling some of that into here so to repaint this panel. And I can go back in and paint over it. It's just a back and forth process. Actually, I didn't get my whole panel there painted. Actually, I think that panel needs to be lighter. So this is cadmium yellow medium plus a tiny bit of mud plus white. Yeah, that's going to be our brightest panel, because the light is coming in from the left, and so the sunlight hits that panel more directly. Then this panel is light, but it's not quite as light. And this panel is a little bit darker. I'm just painting over that dark that I had there already. So I want that to drop back. Now this back edge of the umbrella, I want to make that a little bit lighter so we see it. And this comes around. Now I'm bracing my hand on the mall stick. This we got at the Container Store. It's a hook used to lift clothes off of a tall clothes rack. And you can go to Container Store, and I think you put in garment hook. And last I heard, one of my readers looked on the Container Store website, and they're $19.95, which is exactly the price that Jack and I paid for them when we got them in like 1997. So that's not bad that that hasn't gone up in price. On the top of these umbrellas is a little air vent . Hard time keeping my hand steady even with the mall stick today. It's just... use a little bit bigger brush. I think that'll pull my paint better. Now I hold it at the tail end of the brush because that gives you more control on this long-handled brush. And there's a little flap. Well, let me do the little top part. Go ahead and paint it dark. And it attaches at each of the rungs of the umbrella coming down. little bit darker here. Then the light catches it where it flops up, because these are very loose fabric here, so that the air can, if the wind blows, then that's air vents, so the umbrella won't blow over. So they say. Jack and I have certainly had many umbrellas blow over, even with these little air vents, but they do help. Now we're going to do the little side panels. Now these little flaps that come down are going to be darker because the light comes from above, so the flat panel on top, or the flatter panel on top, receives more light, whereas these upright pieces don't get as much sunlight. This one will still be a little bit lighter than what I've got it. Come around. This is going to be a little bit darker. And this one's going to even be darker. Thought this would be fun. It gives us our complementary colors of the red, yellow, and blue there on the umbrella, the table, and the geraniums back there. Now I'm taking a little bit of my lighter color. In fact, I'm going to make even a little bit lighter mixture, add a little bit of white to that cadmium yellow medium, plus a tiny touch of mud, adding some white to that. So then I'm going to just brace my hand on the canvas here to do this. I want to highlight that leading edge of the umbrella. And then on this panel, I'm going to do the same thing. It's just, I want these panels to come down just a little bit more. And the panels sort of, as they go over these ribs of the umbrella, they kind of dip down on that edge, and then this edge gets a little more light. It comes up and around there. Now I'm going to go ahead and make my dark panel here. Bit darker. I'm going to hold my brush back here. There we go. And then I'm going to bring this panel down just a little bit. Sometimes these little details in the background, even though they're not super detailed, take longer than some of the bigger stuff up front. But they add, it's just nice to have a little something back there for the viewer as they're looking through the painting. Gives them visual interest. They can feel like they want to just go back there and sit on that little patio and look out at the ocean and listen to the waves and the song of that beautiful water. Now I'm going to add the little top to the umbrella pole that holds the umbrella up. And a little light onto that. Use that top. Not much. Now I've got to just couple these edges. I need to soften that. So it goes back. And then I want to pull this line back here. I can do this time and we'll just see. Keep pulling up my paint from my little sketch where I changed it, and since it's not dry, it's just pulling that darker color into my lighter color. There we go. Now I need to do this. And now I'm going to lighten this front edge of this panel. Let that really get light there where the sunshine hits it. And that just lifts that front edge of that umbrella up. I can do this. Almost have it. Almost have it here. And there we go. I'm going to make my little highlight just a little bit lighter on my pole, on the top of that. And there we are. There's our terrace and windmill, and our background is complete. Thank you so much for watching my YouTube videos. I also have a blog where I show this complete step-by-step process. The link is in the description below. It's also on the final frame of my YouTube video, along with my website address. Please feel free to ask questions if you like. You can always ask them in the comments section. And I just really, really appreciate you watching my videos. You have a fabulous day.